I did my BE degree in civil engineering in SCAD College of Engineering and Technology, Cheran Mahadevi. Our civil department professors guided us, inspired us, and made us what we are today. Our department has a good laboratory facilities with all equipments that help me in my practicals and in my projects. In our department, we had special and personal mentors who guided us in campus drives and helped us in choosing our career. Finally, I want to thank the management, our principal, our head of the department, our professors, my parents and my friends for giving me such a wonderful college life and for traveling with me in this four-year journey. I'm proud to be a SCADian. Thank you.
பேசுகிறோம் ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் எங்கள் பையன் சிவில் இன்ஜினியர் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஃபைனல் இயர் படிச்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கிறான். இந்த வருஷத்தில் அவனுக்கு பெஸ்ட் அவுட் கோயிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட் அவார்டு கொடுத்துருக்குறாங்க, ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம். 4 வருஷத்தில் எங்கள் பையன் ஒரு அரியர் போடாமல் அவனை நல்ல மாதிரி படிக்க வச்சு அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸுக்கு சார்களுக்கு ரொம்ப நன்றி தெரிவிச்சுக்கிறோம். இப்போ 2 கம்பெனிலையும் அவன் வேலைக்கு செலக்ட் ஆகிருக்கிறான். ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் அவனுக்கு படித்து கொடுத்த துணையாக இருந்த அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸ், சார், பிரின்ஸிபால், ஸ்டாஃப், ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாத்துக்கும் எங்களுடைய மனமார்ந்த நன்றி தெரிவிச்சுக்கிறோம்.
Thank you.
Loda Shobhya from Tirunelveli. I did my BE degree in Civil Engineering in SCAT College of Engineering and Technology, Cheran Mahadevi. Our Civil Department professors guided us, inspired us and made us what we are today. Our department has a good laboratory facilities with all equipments that help me in my practicals and in my projects. In our department, we had special and personal mentors who guided us in campus drives and helped us in choosing our career. Finally, I want to thank the management, our principal, our head of the department, our professors, my parents and my friends for giving me such a wonderful college life and for traveling with me in this four-year journey. I'm proud to be a SCADian. Thank you.
பேசுகிறோம் ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் எங்கள் பையன் சிவில் இன்ஜினியர் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஃபைனல் இயர் படிச்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கிறான். இந்த வருஷத்தில் அவனுக்கு பெஸ்ட் அவுட் கோயிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட் அவார்டு கொடுத்துருக்குறாங்க, ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம். நாலு வருஷத்தில் எங்கள் பையன் ஒரு அரியர் போடாமல் அவனை நல்லவாறு படிக்க வச்சு அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸுக்கு சார்களுக்கு ரொம்ப நன்றி தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறோம். இப்போ ரெண்டு கம்பெனியும் அவன் வேலைக்கு செலக்ட் ஆகிருக்கிறான். ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் அவனுக்கு படித்து கொடுத்த துணையாக இருந்த அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸ், சார், பிரின்ஸிபால், ஸ்டாஃப், ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் எல்லாத்துக்கும் எங்களுடைய மனமார்ந்த நன்றி தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறோம்.
Shubhya from Tirunelveli. I did my BE degree in Civil Engineering in SCAT College of Engineering and Technology, Kiran Mahadev. Our Civil Department professors guided us, inspired us and made us what we are today. Our department has a good laboratory facilities with all equipments that help me in my practicals and in my projects. In our department, we had special and personal mentors who guided us in campus drives and helped us in choosing our career. Finally, I want to thank the management, our principal, our head of the department, our professors, my parents and my friends for giving me such a wonderful college life and for traveling with me in this four-year journey. I'm proud to be a SCADian. Thank you.
ராஜாவுக்கு அப்பா அம்மா பேசுகிறோம். ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் எங்கள் பையன் சிவில் இன்ஜினியர் டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஃபைனல் இயர் படிச்சுக்கிட்டு இருக்கிறான். இந்த வருஷத்தில் அவனுக்கு பெஸ்ட் அவுட் கோயிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட் அவார்டு கொடுத்துருக்குறாங்க, ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம். 4 வருஷத்தில் எங்கள் பையன் ஒரு அரியர் போடாமல் அவனை நல்ல மாதிரி படிக்க வச்சு அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸுக்கு சார்களுக்கு ரொம்ப நன்றி தெரிஞ்சுக்கிறோம். இப்போ 2 கம்பெனிலையும் அவன் வேலைக்கு செலக்ட் ஆகிருக்கிறான். ஸ்கேடு காலேஜில் அவனுக்கு படித்து கொடுத்த துணையாக இருந்த அத்தனை டீச்சர்ஸ், சார், பிரின்ஸிபல்,
some consequences. The first one is freshwater scarcity, and the second one is pile of garbage, and the third one is collapse of traffic, and the fourth one is air pollution. So why do these consequences or problems arise? Because of lack of investment in the infrastructures, or maybe due to the lack of technological enhancement to draw water from rivers or any other sources, which may be aquifer or something. Or next thing, pile of garbage. So why do this pile of garbage has been a big problem for the disposal? So we people create a lot of garbage which cannot be disposed in a proper way. So which means now we dispose garbages in an engineered landfill. So that technology alone is not enough for disposal. So some other technologies, which means IoT or sensors oriented technologies, must be adopted to take over this consequence. And next thing is collapse of traffic. So this traffic is a great problem which leads to accidents, is it? So collapse of traffic can also be curtailed by these IoT technologies. And then last one, air pollution. So air pollution is caused due to some release of gases, toxic gases, which may affect the human beings. So these problems should be curtailed so that we can lead a peaceful life in this environment. So to make an environment healthier and to make the surroundings lively, we need to adopt smart cities. So I told this, what are the challenges and how can we cope up with these challenges? So these challenges can be coped with converting our city into a smart city, which is a networked and intelligent city. So in that smart city, our quality of life will be very well with a lower consumption of the resources. So what is a smart city? Smart city is nothing but a sensing, networking, analysis, and control. So these all factors put together forms a smart city. So something or some process which can be sensed, and the process information which can be networked, and that networked data which is analyzed, and with that analyzed data, the process can be controlled without creating any harmful systems. So this is a smart city. The complete definition of a smart city. A smart city is a municipality that uses information and technology to increase operational efficiency, share information with the public, and improve both quality of government services and citizens' welfare. So the main thing in a smart city is it builds a way between a people, that is population, citizens, and the government. So once a citizen got a problem, it is directly sent to the government through internet of technologies. So that can be rectified as soon as possible with the help of a smart city. So next, let us see about the features of developing a smart city. So what are the features? So we are having some features which are enabled.
That forms a smart city. So something or some process which can be sensed, and the process information which can be networked, and that networked data which is analyzed, and with that analyzed data, the process can be controlled without creating any harmful systems. The complete definition of
ஆச்சு அங்க தகவல் வந்துச்சு அப்புறம்
மேம் சாரி ஃபார் தி இன்டரப்ஷன் மேம் கைண்ட்லி மியூட் ஆல் த பார்ட்டிசிபென்ட்ஸ் மேம் தட் ஒன்லி இட் வில் பி எஃபெக்டிவ் ஃபார் தி பிரசன்டேஷன் ஐ திங்க் கௌரி வெங்கடேஸ்வரன் மேம் ப்ளீஸ் அன்மியூட் யூ
Okay, now sorry for the interruption. Let us move back to the session. Okay, now let us see about the features of developing a smart city. So what are the features? Here are some features. That is promoting mixed land use in area-based development. And next one is housing and inclusiveness. And next one is creating walkable localities. And next one, preserving and developing open spaces. And the next one is promoting a variety of transport options. And the next one, making governance citizen friendly and cost effective. And the next one is giving an identity to the city, applying smart solutions to infrastructures and services in area-based developments. So now let us see these features in depth. So first one is promoting mixed land use in area-based developments. So what are these area-based developments? So area-based developments in depth deals with the planning for unplanned areas. So what are these unplanned areas and what are these planning? So it is generally the town planning or the urban planning. The areas are not well planned, it cannot be used in an efficient way. So to use the land areas in an efficient way, we must adopt the planning system for the cities. So for this planning system, the states will enable some flexibility in land use and building bylaws to adapt to the change. Then next one is housing and inclusiveness. So what are housing? To make land and house available for everyone. In this current situation, some are homeless. So to make everyone available with a shelter, this system must be surely adopted. So expand housing opportunities with low-cost buildings and with available, completely available resources that could be that could be very efficient for all the citizens. And next one is creating walkable localities. So what are these walkable localities? So ஒரு நிமிஷம் இருங்க சார், யார் அவர் நின்றுடுச்சு. So creating walkable localities. So how can we create these walkable localities? By town planning or well planning or efficient planning. So when we do efficient planning, we can create walkable localities. What are these efficient planning and what are these walkable localities? Once we are planned for a city, it is not only planned for vehicles or not only planned for housing or commercial activities. So all these space area should be equally distributed and it should be well planned. Now how can we create walkable localities? So these walkable localities should be created also for the pedestrians and cyclists, which can offer a solution to reduce congestion, so that the air pollution due to less vehicular use, the air pollution can also be reduced, which can boost the local economy also. Next one is preserving and developing open spaces. So what are these open spaces? These open spaces can also be called as the green spaces. So what are these green spaces? Green spaces are something which has covered by the leaves, trees, which are environmentally friendly ecosystem. So some of the green spaces which comes under these open spaces are the parks, playground, recreational spaces. So in order to enhance the quality of life, we need to preserve these open spaces. so we can breathe a good air in those open spaces. Next one is promoting a variety of transport options. So how can we promote a transport option? Through transit oriented development. So what is this transit oriented development? So transit oriented development is nothing but a compactable and walkable, which is pedestrian oriented, with a mixed use of communities, which is covered by, so the community is well covered by a high quality train system. So this is it is explained here. Nation, that is the last mile transport spaces, which are equally provided with a transit stop. And this transit stop is surrounded, 2000 feet is surrounded by the required areas, that is residential area, open spaces, and office and core commercial areas. And these spaces are supported by the pedestrian roadways, and the whole area should be surrounded by a train system. This is a well-planned organization. Then next, this is the survey which is taken in Bangalore, first and last mile connectivity diagram. So in this, the origin is a house, and from the house we reach, in the down diagram we can see we reach a metro or suburban railway or a BMTC, which is a bus service. So and we reach the next bus stop, where in this, from the bus stop to the destination we take a walk or through a cycle or a motorcycle or an auto to reach our desired destination. This is one pathway. And the next pathway is a direct travel. So from the house to the destination, we travel through cars or any other mode of transport, which means auto rickshaw or a flight or something else. So this is the first and last mile connectivity of a transport system in a smart city. And next is making governance citizen friendly and cost effective. So what is it? The government should be citizen friendly. So in order to create a smart city, the main role is between the government and the citizen, is it? So making governance citizen friendly and cost effective is the main part of a smart city. So in earlier days, we would write a letter of complaint and we would give it to the collector for the clearance of those complaint, and we will wait. So in so this is the earlier stages. But now through online, we are typing our complaint and we are sending it, and it is rectified in a soon way. So this is an improved smart city process. So this makes the governance a citizen friendly, and it reduces the cost, since we don't want to move to that locality weekly, daily, or something else. In the place where we are, we can connect it to the internet. So this leads to a smart city development. And next one is giving an identity to the city. So how can you give an identity to the city? By giving best local cuisine, health center, educational center, arts and craft, culture, sports goods, furniture, hoistry, textile, and dairy. So these are some of the factors which can make your city a best identity. And here I'll give an example for Tirunelveli city, which identifies it. So here is it, which is an Alaiyappa temple, Oxford of South India, schools for hearing and visually handicapped students, and we have Asia's second largest theater and spa of South India, and the only perennial river in South India, and one of the largest district jail in Tamil Nadu, and its special Alva city. So Tirunelveli city is specially identified for these contents. So likewise, you can provide an identity for your city also, which makes it a smart city. And next one is applying smart solutions to the infrastructure and services in area-based development. So what are area-based development? So to make it less vulnerable to disaster, using fewer resources. So using fewer resources, which means available resources, we can make our city or society as a less vulnerable to disasters, which means we can prevent it in the place where we are. Using cheaper services through smart city. And next we are going to see about the components of smart city. So what are the components of smart city? which is smart manufacturing, smart government, mobility or Wi-Fi, smart or digital citizens, open data, smart health, smart farming or agriculture, smart buildings, smart grid or energy or utilities, and smart transportation. These components all put together can be make a smart city a wiser one. Next one, there are just few things that make a smart city a very smart. When comparing smart cities with normal cities, it is clear that there are lots of ways that citizens and government alike can benefit. So not only the citizens, but all the government can also be benefited with this smart city. So how can a smart city be benefited? Only by using a technology, and the citizens also should follow these technologies. Now, let me explain about the six technologies without which the smartness of a city can never be enhanced. So what are those six technologies? ICT, information and communication technology, Internet of Things, sensors, geospatial technology, artificial intelligence, and blockchain. These are the six technologies which make a city smart city. So let us see about the information and communication technology. So information and communication technology is builds bridge between citizens and the government, where in this through this ICT, citizens can directly interact with the government. In turn, the government can build a city with the choice of its citizens, which means the demand of the citizens is being recorded by the government, and these demands should be rectified by creating a pool of resources for those citizens. And these are the ICT oriented works which are which can be rectified by using by creating a smart city, which is vehicle tracking, routing, delivery scheduling, radio frequency, barcoding, inventory management, address systems, freight auditing, supplier management, and EDI. So these can be done with the use of an information and communication technology. Next, we are going to see about the IoT, which is Internet of Things. So Internet of Things, what are Internet of Things? Internet of Things is like veins of the city, which spread over all across the city, connecting each dot. So how do this IoT works as a part of a smart city? It manages a lot of resources of that smart city. So what is an IoT? It creates an interconnection via internet and computing devices embedded in every objects, which enables them to send and receive data. So we say in a smart city, the government and the citizens have a friendly relationship, that their problems are directly conveyed to the government, and the government also rectifies the same. So how can be done? So this can be done. The government and the citizens relationship can be maintained by these IoT systems, which can send and receive data. In general, the term IoT refers to the rapidly growing number of digital devices. So the digital devices combined together forms an IoT system. Okay. Includes smart sensors and other devices, because these sensors can sense what is happening in the environment. So these problems can be transferred to the organization which is governing that through the data through the signal format, and these signals, when received by the government, can be converted into the statement what problem is faced by the citizens and how can it be rectified. The solutions can also be got from these IoT system itself. Using these IoT, how can we get benefited? So the benefits are, we can manage the traffic, and we can reduce the pollution, and we can make better use of infrastructures and keep the citizens safe and clean. These are the components of the Internet of Things, which is, the main component is the sensor. The sensor provides data received from the citizens, and that can be sent to the organization that is going to rectify it. And next one is the connectivity. The data can be collected by the sensors, but the data is to be connected to the destination where it is going to be rectified. So the connectivity is the main component. And next one is the people and processes. The people who use these Internet of Things should properly provide the data. That means the data which they are having some problem with, and the process that is to be made for them to rectify the same. So the people connect to the government through the sensors, which combine together the IoT system. Next one is why we use this IoT. Dynamic control of industry and daily life. So the daily life can be influenced by an IoT, which make it as a better environment. And next, it improves the resource utilization ratio. So using these IoTs, we can manage our resources, because it gives an alarm. How much resources do we use a day? And then integrating human society and physical system. Next one is flexible configuration. So we can configure our IoT system based on our requirements. And next one is acts as technology integrator. And next one is universal inter-networking. So anyone can find any data, identify or find any of the information which they are required through this Internet of Things. Next one, we are going to see about the sensors. So what are sensors? So something which can be sensed. So which is sensed? Human beings are the great sensors, but up to a limited edition, is it? So something which can be touched, we can see a color, or we can feel a smoke, or a temperature, or a cold, so vibrations. So these are something which can be sensed. So these factors can be sensed by a sensor, is it? So sensors are crucial component of any intelligent control system. A process is improved based on its environment. So if we want to develop an environment, we should place a sensor which is aware of a control system. So if we place a sensor, it would analyze that environment. So that analyzed data will be sent to the any receiver. So if there is any ups and downs, we can manage it. The operations can be controlled through remote system. So using these sensors, we don't want to move to that vulnerable place or somewhere. We can control that moment where we are. So that is the use of sensors. And there are some types of sensors which are used in IoT. The first one is accelerator sensor, proximity sensor, IR sensor, and then gas sensor, temperature sensor, chemical sensor, smoke sensor, motion detector sensor. So in malls or in somewhere theaters or wherever you go for outside, you can see some of the sensors in our daily life. So here are some explanations. First we can see about the accelerator sensor, which is used to measure the acceleration exerted upon an environment. So if an environment is being accelerated, it can be sensed by accelerator sensor. Next one is proximity sensor. So proximity sensor detects the presence of nearby objects without any physical contact. Next one is the IR sensor. So these sensors are used to detect the motion of an object through infrared radiation. So gas sensors, these are the electronic devices that detect and identify different types of gases. And next one is the temperature sensor to detect the temperature changes in the environment. And next one is the chemical sensor, which measures or detects the chemical quantities and that is converted to the sensed chemical data into electronic data. And next one is the smoke sensor. It is a device that senses smoke, which means which is going to in a place that is going to be a fire accident. So that can be rectified by using a smoke detector, which is a sensor. And the last one is the motion sensor. It is an electronic device that is designed to detect and measure the movement. So these sensors plays a very vital role in the Internet of Things, which is each and every movement of an object can be perfectly sensed. Next
participants, kindly mute your mic. Google.
And next one is the geospatial technology. So what is this geospatial technology? So geospatial technology provides a necessary framework for collecting data and transforming observation in this collection to facilitate a software-based solution around smart infrastructure, which means it provides a framework for collecting data. And these data is transformed to a software-based solution system. This data, which are software, which are analyzed by the softwares, and which provides as a solution to create smart infrastructures. So this is the geospatial technological point, which is first one is GNSS and positioning. So it refers GNSS, Global Navigation Satellite System. So through satellites, we will get a signals from the space, and that signals are transmitted into datas, the datas related to positioning and timing. So the GNSS receiver receives the datas related to the positioning and timing system, with which we can identify the location. So in this environment, we can locate anyone from anywhere through these GNSS and positioning software. The next one is GIS or spatial analytics. So spatial analytics is nothing but the advanced geographical information system. So this spatial analytics is a logical processing of spatial data. So the spatial data through the geographic information system is processed logically into a spatial data. So this spatial data is created using the topological, geometric, or geographic properties, which are useful for the analysis of the environment. And next one is the Earth observation. So what is the Earth observation? The physical, chemical, and biological systems of the planet is analyzed through this Earth observation. So it is nothing but a survey using remote sensing. So remote sensing technology is used in this Earth observation process, a normal surveying technique, which encompasses the collection, analysis, and presentation of the data related to the physical, chemical, and biological system. And next one is the 3D scanning. So what is a 3D scanning? It is a real world object scanning system, which is the 3D scanning will analyze the objects in the environment and it collect data. So what will be the data? How is the environment? What is the shape of the environment? And what is the color of the environment? So using these colors, we can identify which is the blue color indicates the water resources, green color indicates the green environment. So likewise, using these colors, we can distinguish the topographical area through this 3D scanning system. And next one is the artificial intelligence. So what is an artificial intelligence? So it is a man-to-man interaction. So artificial intelligence is widely used in intelligent traffic management and healthcare facilities. So mainly in healthcare facility. So how can artificial intelligence can be used in a healthcare facility? So artificial intelligence may be, for a best example, we can say a robot. So using these robots, so how can a healthcare be given to a individual or a patient? So using this using these robots, we can make it interact with the patients who are in need of the great explanation of what they have. So what is the problem within them? So frequently they can contact these so frequently they can contact these robots through IoT so that they can be satisfied with the healthcare presentation artificial intelligence in context of smart cities. So smart city, so in the concept of smart city, what is artificial intelligence? So I explain now about the healthcare facility. So now we can make use of the energy. So how can energy be facilitated by using artificial intelligence? So in a system where energy spikes tend to happen, this artificial intelligence usually occur and under which circumstances, and this information can be used for better management of power grid. Next one is the blockchain. So what is a blockchain? So blockchain is nothing but, so you can now be,
excuse me ma'am, so can you please show your PPT?
Yes sir, wait sir, I'll provide it for a while. Okay, let me start the session. Now we can see about the blockchain. So now we have discussed a lot of things. So these things can be, you can have a doubt when we are sharing our informations or datas with these internets, will it affect our security? So definitely not. So using these blockchain technology, you can secure your data flow. So it is given by an example. So if a user requests for a transaction, the transaction is created into a block. So this block is broadcasted to all the nodes of the network which is connected to that transaction, and this networks analyze the nodes, that is the block connected to it, and it verifies whether it is safe, and then it is and then the block is added to the chain of network. And then it is transacted, the transaction gets verified and then it is executed. So likewise, the blockchain works on the security process in this IoT system to make it as a smart city. So next, what are the five components of the smart city? So five components: smart infrastructure, air quality management, traffic management, smart waste management, and smart parking. So what is a smart infrastructure? So smart infrastructure means environmentally friendly infrastructure and sustainable infrastructure, a sustainable environment that leads to a smart infrastructure should be provided. So however we are surrounded by digital technologies, and that should be also sustainable, and it should be, and it should it should not affect the regular being of any humans. So it can be done by this energy efficient technologies which use IoTs. For example, here I have given a smart lighting system. So this smart lighting system can control the energy spikes by if a person is moving in a roadway, the light can be in a brighter form. So if nobody is in that road, the light maybe get dimmer. So the brightness level can be adjusted, and the roadway and the use of the roadway can be tracked using this smart lighting system. So which comes under the smart infrastructure. So these are the smart infrastructure factors, and all the city oriented factors comes under this smart infrastructure. Next one is the air quality management. So it is a cloud-based software. So this software uses the daily data, which means how much quantities of pollutants enter the atmosphere, and it also can predict 3 to 5 days of data how much would be the pollution in that locality. So this software can leads us to control the air quality and air management system. The next one is the traffic management. So this traffic management provides pavement integrated sensors. So this traffic management system is oriented with pavement integrated sensors. So we can provide a space for not only for the vehicles and the metro trains, but also for the pedestrians and cyclists, so that they can also move in this society. And then in real time process, so it is in Mumbai. So in Mumbai, they adopt a traffic management system in which we wait. So normally we wait in the traffic signals, is it? So in the traffic signals, if any of the person is urged, and if he makes a horn sound, the traffic signal itself senses it as a noise pollution, which is greater than 85 decibel. So this noise pollution, how it can be, so the sensor itself creates a 90 seconds extra signaling time, which stops everyone from that signal to move. So likewise, it can be the traffic problem can be rectified using this traffic management system. Next one is the smart parking. So smart parking is nothing but vehicular parking system. In the smart parking system, the sensors via smartphone. So using the smartphone, if a driver is using a smartphone for searching space for parking, these sensors detect where the vehicle left and where is the space free for the parking of next vehicle. And this data is sent through IoT through that smartphone of the driver, and the driver is now available for free parking space where he can park his own vehicle. So through the smart parking system also, there's a livelihood could be enhanced. And last one is the smart management system. So this smart management system is to optimize the efficiency of the waste collection. So how is the waste collected in a smart waste management system? So we have to use a Wi-Fi enabled dustbins. So these Wi-Fi enabled dustbins send an alert to the via phone. It may be through a smartphone. It's sent to an alert to the collection driver who is in the collection system that dustbin is full and it has to be emptied. And this notification, once reached the driver should travel to that destination where the dustbin gave data, and he should empty that dustbin and make it free available for the next disposal process. So likewise, a smart waste management system works in this environment. And also, we can use a low-cost passive sensors. These sensors give information to the active sensors of that locality, and that active sensors data is transferred and sent through the cloud platform. And this cloud platform gives a response to the truck driver to dispose the vehicle. To dispose the garbage, whether it has to be sent to the recycling plant or the manufacturing plant or the disposal site, wherever. And next we can see about the challenges of a smart city. So what are the challenges and how it can be rectified? So some of the challenges are lack of confidence, legislation and policy, funding, and then existing infrastructure. So these are some, whatever may be, that if the connectivity is best, we can make a city a smart city. So these problems, these challenges can be rectified by connected objects, engaged citizen, streamlined transportation, environmentally friendly environment and optimal budget planning. So the citizen should be connected active electronic devices which transfer data, and using these data are the devices, the transportation system also to be streamlined, and then these connected objects should be also environmentally friendly, which does not harm any human beings. And last one is the budget planning. So I give brief about the budget planning. In a study, it is estimated that cities can save up to 264.86 of Indian rupees in their overall state budget for every 75 INR Indian rupees they spend on technology. So if we invest 75 rupees in a technology, so it can save 264 rupees from the Indian budget. So don't feel that why do we want to waste our money on the technology? So if you spend on technology, your money will only be profited, not there won't be any loss in your investment or your paid taxes or anything else. So recommended strategies to the government. So some of the strategies which can be recommend to the government is allocate appropriate fund. So if you invest, if you give funds, only these IoTs can be developed. And next one, build competency. So we need to build our inner competency level, which can make us to create an innovative solutions. And next one is favorable policies. So we have to create some favorable policies in order to convert a city into a smart city. So the policies should also be revised. And last one is the benchmark with best practices. So we have to practice the best thing. We have to set a benchmark with the best thing so we can reach it soon as possible. And I have to share something about the role of smartphone. So we all have a smartphone in our hands. So if you from today onwards, if you keenly notice how the smartphone works, you can see in your smartphone that how much water you have to drink a day and how much steps you have taken in a day. So you have taken 3,465 steps in this day. So likewise, you are getting regular data every daily basis. You are getting some data, so weather forecasting. So such data are given through smartphone itself. So these smartphones work on the basis of these Internet of Things technologies, which enhance your daily activities. Then these are some list of smart cities in Tamil Nadu. So we have 12 smart cities in Tamil Nadu, which is Trichinopoly, Tirunelveli, Dindigul, Tanjavur, Tirupur, Salem, Vellur, Coimbatore, Madurai, Erode, Thoothukudi, and Chennai. So these are the 12 smart cities of Tamil Nadu. So here after watch what are the activities being taken over in these smart cities and what are the developments we are making in these smart cities and where we are reaching through these smart technologies and how do we get benefited with these smart technologies. So conclusion means the future of IoT is unlimited. As I explained now, this is expandable. IoT is not a limited version. It based on our innovative ideas and citizens' inner responsibility, so we can make the IoT a great success and a smart city a greater success. So it not only depends on the technology, but also the individuals, the peoples who use these Internet of Things. So if we have a good knowledge about these daily activities, we can easily get adopted in these technologies because our day-to-day life is being enhanced by these Internet Things. For example, in homes, we use washing machines. So these washing machines can be connected to your smartphones, which gives you the data in your smartphone. You can take the data that how much water your washing machine have used and how much of energy it has used and what are the resources being spent in your in that activity of cleaning. Or it may be your car. If your car adapted with this IoT technology, so the car can itself diagnose the problem which is happening inside it. It can self diagnose the it can self diagnose its problem, and it also suggests a solution. So we don't want to move for a mechanic outside and wait for him to rectify our problem. So likewise, it enhances our daily activities. So the future of IoT is unlimited, and you also cope up with this environment and live a livelihood life. And these are the references where I had made this PPT. And stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Hope you you had a good session, and it was so informative. Thank you.
Participants, is it possible to share the presentation or the to the participants?
Sir, we would post it in the comment box, YouTube live comment box.
Okay. You mentioned that for automotive, we can use the IoT techniques. So
sorry, sir, we can't get you. Once again, please.
For a car, for a passenger
car. Yes, for a car.
Your last slide, you mentioned that
yes, sir.
We can use the IoT, right?
Yes, sir.
So, for an example, for your specific topic, smart city thing, if you are using IoT, it is not a big issue, like keeping the sensor and collecting the data and those things and all, it won't be a big issue. But if you are taking a small car, very small component, not a component, even if you take a car, in that particular car, if you are using IoT and keeping the sensor and all, will it occupy space or?
We are available of a lot of sensors. It may be a low cum sensor, a low weight sensor, whatever. So we can use any type of sensor. It ranges. It depends upon our use. It depends upon an individual's requirement. So if he is required with that sensor, it can be fitted to that car and he can use it. It depends on the requirements of individual persons. It does not affect any space areas or anything. I suggest.
Yeah, ma'am. I have a few on clarification. So how do sensors send the data? So
it is a cloud oriented process. The data through interconnection via internet is sent to somewhere which is being operated. So we can say that receivers. So there are some organizations which receive those. So some satellite signals are transferred to the NASA, is it? So like this NASA receiver. So like well, there is somewhere a receiver gives those data and it can
transfer. Hello?
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Ma'am, using IoT, how to enhance the full supply chain, ma'am?
The data from the terminal.
Can't get you.
Using IoT, how to enhance the full supply chain, ma'am?
How to enhance
the food supply chain using IoT? What are the different types of sensors used?
Sir, there are many types of sensors used based on our requirements. So fire sensors or the smoke detectors and accelerator detectors, proximity sensors. It is so what is our requirement? So based on our requirement, we can create a sensor which can be used in this system. So it is not sensors are an inventory product. It's your innovation. So innovation is unlimited. You can make anything what you are required.
Oh, before,
hello, ma'am.
before using, I'm sorry, let me complete the question. Before using the IoT technique for any system or any component, do we need to train that system? For an example, I'm going to use the sensor. So if the sensor sends the particular parameter, then if the parameter exceeds certain value, then it has to inform to the user, like your target has been achieved. That kind of thing, if the sensor has to inform to user, means then do we need to train first?
Yes, sir, surely we need to train.
Okay, but the thing is, we need to train means for as a user, I may not know the exact value. For example, if I'm going to use a IoT technique for any component, basically I'm a mechanical engineer. Okay, so I'm going to use this IoT technique for any one of the machineries. So in some situations, I may not know if this particular parameter reaches this value, then it will be the worst case. That kind of target value, if I may not know, then how can I use IoT technique in that?
It is simple. So if we purchase something, I give a simple example. So if we purchase a water bottle, we know how much quantity of water it can contain, is it? So it is written in that bottle itself. So likewise, the sensors, so we have specific sensor for specific activities. So the specification will be given to in that sensor itself. So we need to identify which specification of sensor we need and we have to purchase it, sir.
So for the various possible combinations, we need to train up the sensor, correct?
Yes, sir.
So all those possible combinations we need to put.
So we can enhance it for our use. You can make it. It is an inventory thing, is it? So we can make it for our requirement.
Yeah, correct. So if it is the case, then see, if I'm having n number of permutation and combination, then for all those combinations, I need to train a sensor before I implement that IoT technique to my system, correct?
So to make sure, we have to train.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any more queries, participants?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm having one query, sir.
I'm also having one query.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Can you explain the IoT connected with the digital twins?
Let me share your thought in the next presentation.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Are you going to take any further presentation regarding this IoT?
So in future, it may be.
Okay.
Madam, I wish to raise one doubt, madam.
Yes, sir.
Madam, actually now the COVID 2019, so because of that, we are huge data has been generated. So what way IoT applied here? So the different in the while going for treatment or any other way, what way the data that is the generated data and the IoT can be combined? Do you have any idea, madam?
Sir, just like sharing the information, it is shared, is it? So in a hospital or in a locality, they may take a survey or using the sensors, they may get the data of those who are affected by this COVID. And these data are available in the internet, is it?
Yeah, yes, actually, right now, IT companies are collecting the requirements. So they are healthcare industry, mostly used for IoT.
Voice is breaking, so, madam.
Yes. Okay. After that, the requirement collecting completed. So they are going to monitor the patient health, the heartbeat and the lungs. So those kind of activities they can measure easily. So those purpose, the IoTs are right now working on it. So might be it is really helpful to do the current situation.
Yes, absolutely, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The discussion is over. And let me hand over the session to Surya Prakash, sir.
Okay, sir. Participants, thank you for your patience listening. So on behalf of Civil Department, participants, thank you for your patience listening. On behalf of Civil Department, actually a very hearty vote of thanks to the honorable delegates who blessed us with their presence and took out their valuable time. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for Mrs. B. Gauri Mangeshwari for an excellent delivery. And also, I would like to extend a special thanks to Mrs.
Thank you, sir.
Sheila Daniel for inspiring us and her moral support. I also wish my gratitude. Gratitude to our principal, Dr. P. Abhidaini, for providing us encouragement and support. I'm very grateful to Mrs. Shar Sheila Daniel, our HOD, for providing us an opportunity to organize this event. I also express my gratitude to Mr. V. Krishnashankar for his technical support in conducting this webinar. Finally, thank our beloved chairman, our vice chairman, our MD sir, our GMD sir, our agency for their fullest cooperation and support and encouragement. Participants, the feedback form for this session is shared in the Google Meet chat room and YouTube live chat section. Kindly fill the feedback session. Within today evening, you will be receiving the certificates. Thank you all for your patient listening. Thank you.
Thank you so much. But we are expecting for a real-time experience, so it may be helpful to all. So can you please give me the next session?
Sir, in Bombay Metro Corporation, the IoT has been implemented in the traffic signal, sir. That is known as a honking signal or punishment signal. If we increase the decibel of the horns, there will be increasing the time limit for waiting in the traffic signals.
I know the details, but we are expecting, so what are the languages are required? So what they are really doing the IoT, so how they are interlinked to hardware to software, so those kind of stuff we need to record. So maybe it will help to
all. That will be shared in the next session, sir. Thank you for your suggestion. Next session we'll be sharing these details.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, all the participants.
Okay. Thank you.
Participants, feedback link has been shared in the Google chat room, the Google Meet chat room and YouTube link. Kindly fill out the feedback form for receiving the certificates.
Google Meet room la inga varave illa.
Varum.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, excuse me, sir. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, we are not able to receive that feedback form, sir. We are not able to send the feedback. Some error message is coming, sir. Please check it out. The exam is not currently accepting. It's coming. Please check it out, sir.
Okay, thank you. Sending 14, right?
So feedback form is coming, sir, but we are not able to resend you. We are not able to submit the information, sir.
Try again, ma'am. It has been enabled now.
It's enabled, ma'am.
Sir, it is enabled, ma'am. Sir, but we are not able. Okay, sir. Thank you.
All the participants are requested to fill the feedback.
From Tirunelveli, I did my BE degree in Civil Engineering in SCAT College of Engineering and Technology, Kiran Mahadevi. Our civil department professors guided us, inspired us, and made us what we are today. Our department has a good laboratory facilities with all equipments that help me in my practicals and in my projects. In our department, we had special and personal mentors who guided us in campus drives and helped us in choosing our career. Finally, I want to thank the management, our principal, our head of the department, our professors, my parents and my friends for giving me such a wonderful college life and for traveling with me in this 4-year journey. I'm proud to be a SCADian. Thank you.